guys, welcome. And today I just found out that James was living in my wardrobe for like 4 weeks, leaking all of my video topics. And then he goes and breaks my tripod, so I have to go get a new one. So I got this, the ESDDI VT60. Right then, so here we have the... Right then, so here we have the ESDDI VT60, straight from Amazon, came in this perfectly made cardboard box. On the side we've got foldable, simple operation, personalized series, and a maximum stability, which is what we're looking forward to. Let's pop open the correct end of the box, whip out this bit of foam here, and take a look at the tripod. So here is... a beautiful looking carry bag. You can grab that by the handles there. Slip this straight open. And we've got the tripod itself, lovingly wrapped in plastic here. Slide that out. And take that out of the packaging. Would you look at that? That monster of a tripod there. Move that off to one side. We've got the instruction manual. Looking forward to getting in that. Silica gel, don't eat that. We've got the handle, or the stability handle, for the head there. And we've got just a bunch of extra accessories in case anything falls off or breaks. We've also got this, which is a strap, so you can look really fashionable when you're carrying around your tripod bag. So then, filling out the spec sheet, the tripod is made from aluminium and weighs 3.95 kilograms. It has a minimum height of 88 centimeters, a maximum height of 163 centimeters, and a load capacity of 5 kilograms. It comes in black and boasts a fluid damping head. So let's do a quick overview of all the features. Right then, so let's start off with the feet. At the bottom of all three tripod legs, we have these flat rubber pads, and they allow it to stay quite stable on a flat surface. The rubber grips the floor and keeps the whole thing steady. So that's really good for this hardwood surface or any other kind of flat surface. If we pull this tab here, we can pop the entire flat foot off, move that to one side, and we're greeted with these rubber balls. And these two rubber balls can also grip the flat surface, but are really good in bumpy terrain. So if you're on carpet or grass, these are perfect to use. So yeah, the feet get a check mark from me.
As we work our way up the tripod, we are met with these, the aluminium tripod legs that keep the entire tripod standing up. They feel pretty strong. The base ones, measuring in, according to my vernier caliper, about 20 millimeters, and the top ones, measuring in at around 14 millimeters, they're all hollow, but again, they do feel pretty strong, so that's quite good. Here they are next to a milk bottle for comparison.
We are now halfway up the tripod and we can see a flip clip. There are 6 flip clips on this entire tripod. There are 2 on each leg and they allow us to adjust the height of the tripod. They are quite strong and very hard to undo, but once you're roided up to max strength and max power, you can grab hold of the clip and flip it up and then adjust the height of the tripod, which is, you know, what you want to be able to do. This is both a positive and a negative. The positive being that because it's hard to undo, it won't come undone easily and therefore your height won't change and it won't be an issue. The bad thing being that I'm going to run out of steroids pretty quickly because I'm flipping them up and down quite often. Now that we've reached the top, the fun can begin. As you can see, I've got the carry handle here, and we can attach that to either side, so it's whether you're right or left-handed, or just have a preference of which side you want to control the tripod from. You can attach that straight to it. You can also adjust the height as well, and just screw that on there. The height of the actual head, once you've got the camera attached, can be adjusted like this in a very smooth motion. You can loosen it with this dial on the side and you can see it's quite a steady, smooth motion, unlike my old tripod. This top plate can be removed by unscrewing the screw head on the side here and then sliding out the plate. As you can see, the plate has 2 screws, so you can actually choose whichever screw you want, depending on what your camera supports. You can pop out this little rubber piece here and take out various screws. I'm probably going to use the quarter inch the most. The head can also be rotated like that, quite simply, quite smooth, no clicking sounds like my old tripod, so that's definitely a positive, and I'm looking forward to using that smooth panning motion. The entire head can also be loosened with this, with this dial down here, so you can get a nice rolling action. And if you unscrew it all the way, the entire head can actually be removed from the tripod. So you can see there's a wide range of motion that you can get going on with the top of this tripod, and that again is a huge positive. Way more motion, way more smooth motion than my previous tripod, so all around check marks from me. This works really well and I'm very happy with it. Here is the tripod next to an idiot for comparison. At the time of recording, this tripod was listed for about £126 on Amazon. So, assuming it's all it's cracked up to be, this tripod could be a very good deal. And you know what that means? I actually just broke it. That's plastic, and I've just broken it. I just want to clarify what happened there. I unfortunately just broke the tripod with my level 3 shake test. Just want to 100% clarify, that will never happen in real life. You will never shake the tripod that much, but I thought, hey, let's try it out. And it's clear I have now broken something. This rod here is in fact metal, but the way it attaches onto this piece here is with a little plastic fastener. There is actually a stress point down here as I'm shaking, and that's what's basically snapped off. I'm going to see if there are any spares in the bag. If not, it's time to whip out the epoxy and glue it back together. So just bear with me while I stick the tripod back together. So this is what happened in greater detail. Here is the metal rod that is used to stabilize the entire tripod, and here is the plastic fastener that is used to keep it on the end and moving. The metal rod ends about here, and then the plastic fastener has been inserted, and that's where it broke, which is to be expected, as that is a key stress point for the entire object. Will it happen to everyone? No. Did it happen to me because I was being an idiot? Yes. It wasn't scripted, it wasn't supposed to break, I didn't expect that. If ESDDI want to improve that, instead of using an injection molded piece of plastic there, I would suggest using a die cast piece of metal. I definitely won't be able to break the metal then. So the way I've done this is I've just ripped up a carton from an Amazon package here, and I've got A and B of the epoxy, and I'm just going to mix that together until it's all, perfectly mixed. Look, is this a major issue? No, not really. I was being pretty reckless with the tripod and that's why it broke, but I can see this affecting a few people in certain scenarios. If it is shaken quite vigorously, then it could break. If it falls a certain way and it knocks that weak point, then again it could break. But something to note is that the tripod will still work, even with that piece broken off, and as I've just shown, it can be easily glued back together. My previous tripod had a metal rod with a screw going through it at a 90 degree angle, and that, in my opinion, is a better system than the little plastic fastener, as that's a metal screw. I'm less likely to break metal. Plus, the metal screw was non-proprietary, so if it did break, it could be easily replaced. But like I said, it's not a major issue, so now I'm gonna go back to the tests. So, do I recommend this tripod? Yes, absolutely. It's very sturdy, it keeps all of my videos smooth, and apart from that slight accident that was caused by myself, it's extremely well built. I'm not gonna hold that accident against it because, again, like I said, it was my fault and I've glued it back together and you can't really tell that it was broken. The epoxy has strengthened it and it is now stronger than ever. Look at that. Should everyone get one of these tripods? No, even for me, this is extreme overkill. It's absolutely massive and it has so many features, I won't even use them all. But if you are a full-time YouTuber, unlike me, or you're going to take some beautiful mountain shots and you need a really steady tripod, then yeah, definitely pick this up. But if you're doing something casual, like me, and you're not planning on using it quite a lot, then you can probably find smaller and cheaper ones on Amazon. I'm pretty sure ESDDI also makes some smaller tripods, but they sent me the big one and that's the one I'm commenting on. But yeah, if the build quality and the sturdiness is anything to go by, then their smaller tripods should be just as good. ESDDI also make other products such as green screen and light boxes, which I do hope they send me to try out because I would be extremely grateful and I promise I won't break those. So I do suggest you check them out. I'll put an Amazon link to their product page in the description below.
Hey, what?
So if James broke your previous tripod,
yeah,
and your new one is currently in your video,
yeah,
then what's holding your camera up?
What to say? That you only meant well, cause you did. What to say? That it's all for the best, because it is. What to say?
Thanks for watching. If you want to subscribe, click over here. If you want to watch another video, click over here. And if you want to find out a little bit more about this episode and the tripod, check out this week's episode of MidgetCast.